Special greetings, my dear students. Today, in this chapter, we are going to learn input and output unit. First of all, how we will communicate with a computer. We will communicate with a computer with help of input unit. With help of this input unit, we are communicating with a computer, and whatever instruction we are giving, computer is processing. Computer is processing the information, what task we given, it will complete the task and it will give the answer to us in a form of a, with help of a output device. These are basic things we all know well, but today we are going to learn what are the several type of input devices. Today we will focus on only your input devices. What are the input devices? Kindly students, you think by yourself. Kindly think what input devices coming in your mind. Keyboard, mouse, after monitor. Monitor is input, monitor is the output, okay? Means what input devices you are knowing. Keyboard, a mouse, a stylus, scanner, light pen, screen touch, a joystick, pen drive. This all will come in a form of a input device. Today, in the device, input device, okay, we are going to learn this four plus some more explanation. First of all, keyboard. Okay, actually keyboard is a input device, we know well. I am asking you one question, how many keys are in a keyboard? Can you able to think or can you able to say how many keys are in a keyboard? Students, it's very easy. In keyboard, there are 104. 104 keys are there. And nowadays, so many varieties of keyboard came. Example, nowadays, smaller keyboard also there, bigger keyboard also there. But depend on the size, current era, some keys may vary. But a standard keyboard have always 104 keys. Okay? This is a standard keyboard. Or normal keyboard we can say having 104 keys. Like in this 104 keys we can divide mainly 5 types. This 104 keys we can divide into 5 types. What are the types of keys? Okay, you just you think in a keyboard what keys are there available. Kindly think letters, numbers, after you know well function key, after sir symbol, you may think like this, but this all keys will come under the mainly 5 key types category. Now we can able to see that. What are the types? First one, numeric. First type is a numeric, after control, third alphabet, navigation, after. So first numeric, control, alphabet keys we can say, navigation, and can you able to say any other which key is missing now? Main key. One main key I missed. Can you able to say what is that? Can you able to guess? Yes, it is a function. Function keys. So these are the mainly 5 types of keys available in a keyboard. Whatever keys are you are saying, it will come under this. Now we can go to and after this one more key is a typing. I will say at last. Typing key, I will say at last, but whatever keys you are saying, it will come under this 5 only. Sir, then what is typing? When I am explaining, that time you will understand very easily and clearly. Okay? Now, what are the numeric keys? Simple numbers. What are the numbers? 0, 1, 2, 3, up to 9. 0 to 9 is called the numeric keys. And what is the control key? You know well, CTRL button. CTRL, Shift, after Escape. So this all will come in a control key. Why we are using control key? To use a shortcut. Okay, it is a combination of two or more keys. After that, alphabet. What are alphabet keys? English letters A to Z will come under alphabet key. And navigation key. Navigation means what? Direction, navigating, pointing something. How we will point? With help of the arrow keys. Okay. After function keys, it is very easier, you know well, F1 to F10 plus F1 to F10 plus print screen, number lock, this all will also come under a function keys. Okay, means in a keyboard right side one part will be there, that all things will come under a function key. At last typing key, now is a thing. Can you able to guess what is a typing key? Combination of this all will come under a typing key. Okay, getting now? In this, do you have any doubt? I think so. I hope you're not having any doubt. It is very easier. Okay. After that, mouse. Mouse, we can say it is a pointing device. Mouse is what? Pointing device. In this mouse, there are mainly three types, three categories. Students, in mouse, whatever you are seeing nowadays, it will come under only three types of category. First type is a mechanical. First one is a mechanical and second one is a optical. And third one is a optomechanical. Students, if I have to write an order way, mechanical will come first, optomechanic will come second, and third will come optical mouse. Actually, this is the order way, first, second, third. But why I written in an unorder? Because there is a reason behind that. You will understand what is it now. See, mechanical mouse. What is a mechanical mouse? If you see 2003, or 2000 or 1990s computer, there is a mouse. So there is a mouse. And if you see the downside, there will be a ball. There will be a ball. Nowadays, if you are seeing a mouse, downside you can able to see the light. Am I right? You are seeing mostly everywhere. But if you go to the old mouse, very 10 year before, 15 year before, if you are going, many places you can able to see only this type of mouse. If you see under this, there will be a ball. Sir, what is a ball? In a monitor, on a desk, whenever you are moving mouse, based on this ball rotation, right, left, straight, back, based on, depend on this ball only, your mouse arrow will move the direction. Sir, how it is possible? Very simple thing. This is a mouse. I am drawing inner component. This is the inner component, okay? Don't get confused. So here is a ball. If you see, there will be one harder component like this. Four side harder component. When you are moving, when ball is rotating first side, the front, this will work. So mouse will go up. Right, left, depend on the ball rotation, this four balls, in which direction it is getting signal, depend on that, mouse will move, cursor will move. Now second thing is the optical. Sir, what is the optical? Very simple. Here we are using mouse. Sorry, here we are using a ball. Instead of ball, we are using sensor. Means a light. Whenever you're seeing mouse, some light is there on downside. You can able to, that is a sensor. Based on the sensor move, this arrow will move here and there. Okay. At last is a optomechanical. Sir, this one is a ball. This one is a sensor. And optomechanical means what? Optomechanical means a ball will be there. Instead of this four side, on a ball there will be sensor light. When sensor light is moving, this mouse cursor will move. Only this is the difference. Again, I am saying mechanical mouse, inside ball will be there, four side hardware component will be covered. Optical mouse, only sensor will be there. Depend on your sensor movement, a mouse arrow will move here and there. After optomechanical. Optomechanical means a combination of this ball and the sensor is called optomechanical. And there are several advantages between this. Mechanical mouse, you need a, what is it, a plain area. It should not be, what is it, a shiny one. It should not be shiny one. Sometimes when you are using a keyboard, if desk is a shiny way, or if you are keeping any copy, on the copy, if you any brown sheet you put, mouse will not work because of this reason. Because if it is shiny, that ball will not rotate. After for this optical mouse, you need a one mat. Means we are keeping under that one cover. Mouse we will keep on only that particular area. On the particular sheet. If the sheet is not there, optical will not work. But optomechanical, any type of environment, it will work. These are the several difference. And sir, what is stylus? Stylus, first time we are hearing, correct? So no need to get any confused. You can say stylus as a pen also. You can able to say it is a pen. Whenever you are seeing some movies or your father, some places, a person using tablet with the help of a stick, correct? Some stick will be there. Instead of finger, he will use the, that particular stick. And in tablet also we are using. In a computer also high level, means a touch screen computer, we are using that particular stick. So that particular stick is called stylism. Okay? Don't confuse this. Stylus and light pen. Light pen is a high security, and what purpose we are using light pen? Example, I am the person. Okay, I am the person. If any person like me are doing fake, okay, if my signature is like this, okay, or your signature something, if any third person, okay, unauthorized person, if he is doing my signature, he will do slowly, correct? But in light pen is having one specialty. How much speed I am writing, that speed and the curve, up and down curve is in a, it will be registered in a computer. So the person who is writing slow, it will easily catch he is a fake person. So that is a light pen, means a digital signature. Nowadays in IPL, some games you can able to see, heroes will come, celebrities will come, they will take pen and they will do sign like this in a mirror wall. So that is a light pen, and this is a stylus. Stick you can be able to say, you can say stick also. And what is the scanner? Students, scanner, there are many type of scanner you are going to study in this chapter. So with this one you have to know only the knowledge, only the concept. Okay, so there are few types of scanner. Upcoming video class, I will upload some particular video regarding the scanner, you can see. And scanner is a input device. Okay, so students, this all are the input devices, kindly go through it. And upcoming class, I will explain output unit. Okay, please take care. Thanks for watching.